but because I just...
Let's continue. Dan Gunhunta.
I'm sure he saw the clothes at some point in the investigation.
No, that can't be it. The bag and clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was is if he saw Cherry with it before he died! That's the only possibility!
Cherry? Are you talking about Chihiro?
So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night.
Oh yeah? At what time did you see him on this?
He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
No, that can't be it either. According to Celeste's testimony...
She stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And besides, we asked earlier already, like, if anyone has seen her yesterday. You didn't speak up, Kondo. And just like that, she was gone.
When Celeste noticed it, Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag. If you just ran into him briefly, you couldn't possibly have seen what color the tracksuit was.
Yeah. Yeah.
It would appear you've dug your own grave.
Perhaps. But you handed him the shovel, didn't you? Focus on the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of nonsense.
Ah, now I understand. It was all one big bluff, wasn't it? Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit.
But I don't really buy it. Like, if that's the only plan they had, and they were out of clues, basically.
That's why you said you knew who did it, to put them on edge.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about him from the very beginning.
But why? What made you so suspicious?
That's a good question.
It was because I hate him. Screw that guy. He always talking shit.
There was a certain turning point that tipped me off. Maybe you didn't notice it, Mondo, but you tend to refer to men and women differently. You only call guys dude. For girls, it's chick. And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude. Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
You've noticed such a tiny detail?
Are you a witch? She's a witch! You're positively frightful!
No, I'm not the frightful one. Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Mondo, was it really you? Did you really kill Chihiro?
I didn't kill anyone! You've been all over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth. What gives you the right to treat me like a goddamn criminal?
Yeah! He would never do something like that! This is a false accusation!
It's true. My reasoning on that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
Well, this does present us with a problem. It seems we are all out of leads.
My time has nearly come. That's what my little ghost friend is telling me.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Hifumi, weren't you telling me you'd found some evidence?
Really? What kind of evidence?
Actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about it here calmly, it might not be all that relevant.
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
If you really insist, then... here it is.
Hmm? What do you have there?
It happens to be an e-handbook. I found it laying on the ground, so I scooped it up.
You found it on the ground, right? Then it must belong to... It's my... Sorry, guys. I dropped it. Chihiro's? Mondo's.
I got it! We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
For a fact.
For a fact indeed! I was totally sure I'd found it!
Then it must hold some clue about the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
I imagine the culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
You're right. They're not. They're totally waterproof and shock resistant. It would take an awful lot to break one.
And yet, this one does appear to be broken, as is Leon's, sitting useless in the main hall. For all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there somewhere? How precisely did the handbooks get broken?
How did the handbook break? There's only one possible explanation. Exploiting a bug by hitting its weak point.
I got it!
You mentioned
you already told us before that the handbook has one weak point, didn't you?
Yeah! You remember that? Sure, maybe I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was.
But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in quick succession, then...
Then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness. You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
Huh? You're asking me?
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
But if I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
Just tell us already! Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example? Then allow me to make a special announcement. The weak point of my cutting-edge e-handbook is... When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break!
I flippin' knew it!
You knew it?
Yeah, 'cause I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
Then why didn't you mention that earlier? We didn't even need to ask.
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh? It's because as your sweat evaporates, it creates a cooling layer of air around your skin. If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely get fried. That layer of air would get blown away. That's why you may feel a burning when you move around. So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Wow, interesting. I learned one new fact today.
Me too, Taka.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
Anyway, if you found the victim's handbook in the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
Indeed. Quite the mystery.
What if they found out by accident?
What do you mean by accident?
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness? And it broke. They'd realize it was broken, of course, and it wouldn't be hard to figure out why. And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
I won't say it's not possible, but who would have done something like that? I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
I know some people.
I might know someone who did.
Whoa! Seriously?
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
You, Taka. Nah. It could only have been one person. Mondo, you're up.
Here's my answer! Mondo. Your handbook got broken in the sauna, didn't it?
What?
Why? Why do you keep accusing him?
Mondo and Taka had an endurance contest in the sauna not too long ago, remember? And for the contest, Mondo just so happened to keep his school uniform on. But little did he realize, he'd also left his handbook in one of his uniform pockets. And when it was all over, Mondo discovered that taking your handbook into the sauna could easily destroy it.
No, wait, hold on! You've got it all wrong! He would never kill! I don't accept this! Show me the proof! The actual solid proof!
I don't want to believe it either, but... But I found something that proves it beyond a shadow of a doubt.
Let's test Makoto's assertion. If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken, then that proves that what Makoto said is right.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine!
No, that's wrong!
That was mostly a guess.
Mondo, the handbook you have right now, is it really yours?
The fuck is that supposed to mean?
The broken handbook that was in the main hall. Isn't that one actually yours?
What the heck are you talking about?
What I mean is, I think Mondo swapped his handbook out for one that actually works. I think he took Leon's handbook and replaced it with his own. After all, Monokuma said himself that Leon's handbook never should have broken.
That's right! The punishment it suffered wasn't nearly enough to destroy it.
So then, the broken handbook in the main hall is actually Mondo's, which would mean that the handbook Mondo has right now is actually Leon's, yes?
But doesn't that violate the school regulation that says loaning out your handbook is prohibited?
Well, here's how I look at it. There is a rule about loaning your handbook to another student, but if they're dead, they're not a student. It's kind of a gray area, I admit. But no worries. If anything, it just makes things more interesting. As such, I decree that exchanging handbooks with a corpse is not a violation of the rules.
Well, Mondo, if I'm wrong about this, you're welcome to say so. I'm happy to admit I made a mistake. But...
Son of a bitch!
What's wrong, bro? Come on! Tell him he's wrong! You are wrong! You have to be wrong! Everything you just said is wrong! You made it all up!
Okay, then why don't we look back on this case one more time, from the beginning? That way, everything will become clear, and we'll all see if I was right or wrong.
So let's see, Chihiro is packing to go to the gym. Celeste sees her. Which one will go there? I think it's this one. Alright, so... She quickly hides it, Chihiro. Then she goes to the bathroom, the locker room. Is it this door? No, it's the other place she went to, the boys' room. Reviewing all the options first. Alright, she sees Mondo there. Says hello to him, starts to change up. Is it this one? Yeah, so he's exercising with the dumbbell. He stands up and goes behind Chihiro. And blood splatter. Maybe this one? So he sees what he did. He killed Chihiro. Tries to cover up his crime. He does so by this one. Then he picks up Chihiro. I think that he is cleaning up the crime scene. He picks up Chihiro, he takes her to the girl's locker room. No, but why would that be repeated twice? Doesn't make sense. Something's wrong here. I think maybe the girl's locker room door. Maybe if that worked if I went backwards. He tosses the sauna? No, like that. Maybe it's that one. There's a lot of similar ones, so it's kind of hard to tell. Cause the only ones I'm iffy about are like these two. This one looks just like that one. Well, we'll see. Let me just reenact it and see what happens.
The killer is you! First, let's take a look back to before the incident. Last night, Celeste saw Chihiro in the warehouse, correct? At the time, she was apparently stuffing something into a duffel bag. That something was a blue tracksuit. You can confirm this, right, Celeste? With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime. She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room. But how could the victim, who was apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room? Simple, because she was really a he. Which is why he was able to use his own e-handbook to gain entrance to the boys' locker room. Once inside, he met with someone there. And the person he met was the one who killed him. It seems likely that the killer grabbed the nearby dumbbell, approached the unsuspecting Chihiro, and attacked him. And that's where the bloodstains on the poster and carpeting in the boys' locker room came from. It was likely in the heat of the moment. The body was arranged, but the murder itself felt unplanned. Which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet, then removing the bloody poster, and finally carrying the corpse into the girls' locker room. A girl's handbook was necessary to get into the locker room, of course. But this alone doesn't prove that the killer was necessarily a girl. After all, Sayaka and Junko's handbooks had been placed in the main hall. Using one of those, a boy could get into the girls' locker room without much problem. And that's exactly how the killer did it. With the carpet and the poster they brought with them, they got to work. They changed the layout of the boys' and girls' locker room in what you might call a crime scene switch. That could have been the end of things, but no. Byakuya discovered the body and decided to intervene in the situation, making... So, after stumbling on the crime scene, he went and grabbed the extension cord from the library, and then he got to work. He used the cord to string up Chihiro's lifeless body. Then, using the victim's own blood, he left a grisly message there at the scene of the crime. He wanted to create the illusion that Genocide Jack was responsible for the slaughter. And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of Chihiro's bag and other belongings, there, they planned to destroy the last piece of evidence. Chihiro's handbook. And just as the killer expected, the steamy sauna was enough to ruin the electronic gadget. Somehow, the killer knew that the handbook couldn't stand up to the heat of the sauna, And the reason they knew that is because the sauna had already wrecked their own handbook. And that's how it all played out. Isn't that right, Mondo Iwata?
Wait! No! This can't be right! Where's your evidence? Yeah! Where's your evidence? You need evidence! You need proof! Without any proof, you can't pin any of this on him!
Evidence and Mondo's a killer. That's already revealed itself early in the trial. All I have to do is check that one item of his, and everything will become clear.
Show me some evidence! You're wrong! I won't listen! I refute you! False! Show me some evidence! I won't listen! False! I refuse to vote! Show me some evidence! You're wrong! I won't listen! I refute you! False! Show me some evidence! I won't listen! False! You're corrupt! Show me some evidence!
This should prove it! If my thinking so far is right, Mondo must have replaced his broken handbook with Leon's. In which case, we can just check each of our handbooks right now. Once we do that, we'll...
We don't gotta do that.
Huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I did it. I killed him.
Bro? What are you saying?
I got no choice, man. After hearing all that, I gotta just... give up. Go ahead, Monokuma. Get it over with. Ask for the goddamn verdict.
Roger that!
Wait! Hold on!
No waiting! No holding on!
It's gone longer than I thought it would today, so I guess I'll finish with this execution and his motivation tomorrow. Thanks for watching.